doeth valiantly. Valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly. I shall not die.
Hallelujah.
But live. Yes. And declare the works of the Lord. I shall not die.
Hallelujah.
But live.
Hallelujah.
And declare the works of the Lord. I shall not die. But live.
Yes.
And declare the works of the Lord.
Woo.
The Lord has chastened me sore.
Yes.
But he had not given me over unto death. Hallelujah. The Lord has chastened me sore. How many still alive can raise your hand? The Lord has chastened me sore and had not given me over unto death. Hallelujah. Mark, the 5th chapter.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. And the 25th verse.
Yes. Thank you, God.
Through the 34th verse. And a certain woman which had an issue of blood for 12 years. And had suffered many things of many physicians, and had spent all that she had, and nothing was bettered, but rather grew worse. When she had heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. For she said, if I may touch but clothes, but his clothes, I shall be whole. And straightway, that means immediately,
yeah.
And straightway,
yeah.
The fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that virtue had gone out of him, turned about him in the press and said, who touched my clothes? And his disciples said unto him, thou seest the multitude thronging thee, and saith, who touched me?
Yes.
You see all of these people around the kingdom of this earth, and you see the armor of light. And he looked round about to see her that had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before him and told him the truth. And he said unto her, daughter, thy faith has made thee whole. Go in peace and be whole of the plague.
Yes. Oh, Lord. Father, right now.
Hello.
Hi. Can I speak to Jackie Carter, please?
Speaking.
Hi, Jackie Carter. This is Dr. Crump. How are you?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
I'm doing fine. I'm calling you because I do have the results in and want to know when will you be able to come in and see me.
Oh, can I come today?
Yes. Can you come in at 12 noon?
Yes, I'll be right there.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Mrs. Carter,
yes.
We got the results, and I have to tell you that the tests were positive, and you have ovarian cancer. It's okay. It's okay. Do you have anyone you want me to call for you?
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Healer, healer, healer.
Jesus, Jesus,
healer, healer, healer.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus,
healer, healer, healer.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus,
healer, healer, healer.
Thank you for healing me, God. Hallelujah.
Healer, healer, healer.
It is not a death sentence.
Amen.
Ephesians 6 and 1. Children, obey your parents in the Lord. Well, this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with the promise, so that it may go well with you and ye may be well, live long on the earth.
I love her.
Yeah.
Jesus. They sent therefore and gathered all the lords of the Philistines unto him and said, "What shall we do with the ark of the God of Israel?" And they answered, "Let the ark of God of Israel be carried about unto Gath." And they carried the ark of the Lord of Israel about them.
Wait,
Mary,
okay, let me call you back. no credit card, but the cash. Joe. Master,
look, the bill collectors calling me right here on my cell phone. They said we 3 months behind on the car payment. Didn't you pay that?
Well, I was going to, but I just got a raise on my job.
You got a raise?
I sure did.
When?
Well, it's coming. The boss told me.
Well, you ain't got it yet then.
Nah, I ain't got it yet. But you know, I do know it's coming, but today is Saturday, so Tuesday is going to hit. When we talk again.
Okay, but you ain't going to have no way to get to work on Tuesday because they said they come in and get the car. Wait. Baby, yo, what is this?
Girl, this is my flat screen TV.
Your flat screen TV. We 3 months behind, they getting ready to pick up the car, and you went and got a flat screen TV with a raise you don't have yet?
Yeah, it's coming,
man. Man, you done lost your mind. You just done lost your complete mind.
Wait a minute. But your hair did, nails done, pumps, shoes, I mean, Gucci.
Wait, Gucci who? This ain't no Gucci who unless it was in the thrift store and my head cost $8.95 for a box of perm, thank you. Now how much was that television? Look, we got three kids, Joe gotta go to college. We don't even have life insurance.
But the Gucci shoes were $400. I saw the receipt on the dresser.
You can see it on my dresser. You must have sold $40 for the thrift store. You didn't see $400.
That was two zeros with a decimal point behind it with two more zeros.
See, Joe, that's the problem. How much was this television? How much was this TV, Joe? Because, see, they getting ready to pick up the car, and look, I can't take this no more. Look, this is what you're going to see. Something got to happen.
Hey, you know,
watch this.
You're right. I can't take this no more neither. But you know what? You can search for tomorrow on them bills. Like them stories you watch. But I'm going to let the guy in light lead me in the living room. Hook up his TV.
Give me strength.
And why you stress out over at the General Hospital?
Okay, go on. See, I'm not going to be stressing. Look, Joe, watch this. Watch this. I'm going to tell you what you're going to see. Back and elbows, Joe. Back and elbows, because something got to change. I can't take this. Something got to change, Joe. I can't deal with this no more.
Get out of here.